Help Hippo, better than learning from Wikipedia. This is a heart, atrium, ventricles, big V on the bottom for ventricles. The heart has four valves, remembered by mitri pulls all, mitral tricuspid, pulmonary, aortic. The atrium is the entry in for blood, so let's follow the cardiac blood flow on the left and right sides of the heart. Oxygenated blood, 1, enters into the left atrium, then 2, goes through the mitral valve into 3, the left ventricle, and 4, crosses the midline to 5, exit the aortic valve, and 6, finally goes far to get oxygen to the head and the rest of the body. These systems use up the oxygen, so now the blood is deoxygenated and returns to the heart, where it A, enters into the right atrium, then B, goes through the tricuspid valve, into C, the right ventricle, and D, crosses the midline, to E, exit through the pulmonary valve, and F, goes through the lungs and gets oxygen. So now the blood is oxygenated and returns to the heart, where it 1, enters into the left atrium, and this whole cycle repeats again. Pause and review. Now that we know the anatomy and blood flow, let's look at how the heart functions. Systole is when the heart squeezes hard, and diastole is when the heart is getting a bigger diameter. During systole, the right ventricle only needs to squeeze hard enough to push blood to the lungs nearby, but the left ventricle must squeeze much harder to push blood all the way to the head and body, which is much farther. Because the left ventricle pushes blood farther, that is why you feel like the heart beats on the left side of your body, because the left ventricle squeezes much more strongly. Speaking of the left heart's function, some say that the left side of the heart is the systemic circulation, because the left ventricle pushes blood to the body's systems. However, while the aortic valve is on the geographic right side of the heart, it functions as part of the left side systemic circulation. Pause and review. Help Hippo, better than learning from Wikipedia.